So this is just another quick video, this time to show you how to work out where your centering rafters go and how to work out the length of your walls for a semi-octagonal roof. So these three walls are going to all be the same length, and we need to know the distance from this corner back here so we can mark the center line for our centering rafters. So we know that these corners are 22 and sorry, these corners are a 45 degree angle all the way around here. So that means that the angle between our centering rafter and our first hip is going to be 22 and a half degrees on plan, and the same on this side. So the red ones are all 22 and a half, and the angle between our hips is 45 degrees. So those three green ones are 45 degrees. So it's pretty easy then to take this angle and tan and times that by our half span distance to give us the length of wall one. So tan by 22 and a half degrees times our half span will give us the length of wall one. Now, fortunately, wall two is simply double the length of wall one. So wall one, well, wall 2 equals wall 1 times 2. Pretty simple. So that gives you that distance. Also gives you that distance and that distance. And even though it doesn't look like it, and it still doesn't look like it's right to me, I've measured it so many times, it's not funny. Those two walls are the same length. So it must be an optical illusion. Now, when you come to set this out, another useful measurement is the measurement from the extension of this wall back to this point, or from this corner, a square corner, back to each of these points. So that can be easily obtained by taking away half of wall two or wall one, take that away from your half span, and that will give you this distance here. As I said, might use that when you're actually setting out the octagonal roof on your concrete slab. So there you go, that's how you get the wall lengths for a semi or octagonal roof.